Hey guys, and welcome back to Battlefront Updates and my review of Rise of Skywalker. I actually tried to record this without spoilers first, but realized it was so hard to talk without spoilers that I decided this is going to be a spoiler review. So if you have not seen the movie, I would suggest you to click off this video right now and then go back and watch this video after you've seen the movie. So without out of the way, let's get into the review. So when I got out after the cinema, I've seen the movie twice now, I was really happy. It was probably the happiest I've been of any of the sequel movies, but I've always had this torn feeling when I've gotten out. There's never been a, my god, this was the best movie I've ever seen, it's so perfect. None of the sequel movies has ever had that feeling. It's always been a lot of things going on in my head, so many things to process, and this was definitely one of them, because there were so many things that I wasn't sure if I liked or not. Like, obviously, Sheev is back. You know how much I like Sheev. And I know that's one of the big flaws a lot of people are talking about. How does he get back? And that's something I wish explained. I thought it deserved a bit more of an explanation. But to be fair, Maul fell down, cut in half, survived. Luke fell down on Bespin, survived. The fact that Palpatine, the most powerful Sith in the world, survived that fall is not unlikely at all. It's more about the fact that it was like that. Anakin was supposed to be the chosen one. He was supposed to bring balance to the Force, which he did according to Episode 6, but then that's kind of undone, if that makes sense. That's one of the biggest concerns I have with some of the things that happens in Rise of Skywalker, including Palpatine's return, that it feels like it invalidates a lot of the stuff that has happened in previous movies. I don't have anything against him returning. I think it makes sense. It could make sense, and they could have explained it more, but it's not completely unlikely based on everything else we've seen in the Star Wars universe. It's just that it makes some of the things in the previous movies matter less. And the fact that he created Snoke was a bit strange. He physically created Snoke. There was a bunch of Snokes in a tank there. If he was able to clone a being that powerful in the Force, why couldn't he clone himself? I mean, he's obviously hooked to some serious life support there on this crane that he obviously can't move physically himself, except for the arms, but it's on this crane, and he has his wires and life support going to his body, so he's not in a good shape. And it makes sense if maybe they took his body or his, well, I guess he was still alive at Episode 6 to this planet out in the Unknown Regions, which is a Exegol, a very Sith-heavy planet, so the dark side there probably helped keep him alive for all these years. So the fact, it's not that he does return that bothers me. I like Sheev. I thought that it was really nice to see him back, but it's more about the fact that I don't know, it could have been explained more, it invalidates some of the previous stuff. Now I feel like I'm just talking about Sheev here, but you know, he's my favorite character, so that's why I wanted to dive into. But the rest of the movie, with like everything from the banter between like C-3PO, Poe, Finn, Rey, all of that was great. I thought they really nailed that kind of cheesy part of Star Wars with the jokes and whatnot. They didn't overdo it. They didn't do it too little, in my opinion. So that's something that I thoroughly enjoyed. And some new characters like Babu Frick. Love him. Such a nice guy, although you don't see him too much. So those parts were really good, and the pacing was a little bit messy at the beginning, I will say. I also thought the whole Force heal with Rey came kind of out of nowhere. I mean, they're talking about this dyad in the Force between Kylo and Rey, that's why they're able to do such things, but it's almost too powerful. Like, you stab someone through the chest, oh, use the Force heal and he's good. Why have we not seen more of that before if it's not that hard to perform as it looks like for Rey? I know, one explanation I've heard is that it's a dyad in the Force. It's something that happens only a few generations, like Palpatine did mention, to be fair. So there's probably going to be more explanations to all of this stuff after seeing the movie. But I do feel like it could have been explained more in the movie, if that makes sense. But overall, I like that it wasn't another like Starkiller base. It wasn't very predictable, in my opinion. Yes, he has a huge armada of planet destroying Star Destroyers. Maybe they could have skipped that, or at least the part where every Star Destroyer can destroy a planet. That was maybe taking it a little bit too far, but just the whole the main story with finding Exegol, finding the Emperor, stopping him, was something that I didn't mind. Again, it could have been executed in a better way maybe, but I much prefer that than any of the previous ones, like well, Starkiller Base, for instance, which I really don't like The Force Awakens because it was too safe. That's maybe why it's more popular than these two movies, at least that's what it seems like. But I didn't like that it's safety. That's why I liked they were a bit bold here, with Palpatine and with everything else. And of course, Rey's, and the fact that Rey is Palpatine's granddaughter. That was something I know people have very mixed feelings about. I did not mind that at all. It's something that I remember people speculated even after Force Awakens. I think it would have been boring if she was a Skywalker, to be honest. I would also, however, have liked if she was just a nobody, showing that you don't need to have powerful blood to be a powerful Sith or Jedi, but you can be a nobody. So I'll accept both of those, and the fact that Palpatine even had kids and a grandchild. I don't know, I did not quite expect that. Although it was a twist I preferred over her being a Skywalker. I did like that part at the end though. I mean, they did say, Luke said, blood is not everything, and then Rey took that as, alright, I'm gonna call myself Rey Skywalker, because Palpatine is not really a surname to be proud of if you're not a Sith loyalist. So I also liked that part of the movie. And visually, I thought Exegol was amazing. It was had this really nice Sith vibe, and all this lightning and the sound was something that was fresh but really badass. And I know this is like not really something that is important for someone who's just watching the movie and basing it of what you think about this movie, but having the Sith back and everything from the Sith artifacts to the Sith trying to rise again, Sith loyalists, I liked that they had more of that. I missed the Sith, that's what I'll simply say. I wasn't happy with the whole, the Sith are dead, now it's something new, Kylo Ren and Snoke. I missed the Sith. I liked the rule of two, I liked the way they worked, and now that Palpatine kind of wanted to restore the Sith, I thought that's a nice story. Again, many things could be executed differently, but for me, I like that, simply put. And then seeing Palpatine get all that life energy back from Kylo and Rey, and becoming, well, the badass emperor that he is, with that new red fancy robe, glowing eyes, I just love that. However, the end fight, I thought that was very lackluster. Like, has he not learned yet to not just shoot force lightning until he dies? I mean, Mace Windu, kind of same mistake against Vader, same mistake. Does he never learn? Like, he's getting fried by his own force lighting and he still keeps shooting until he dies. I really thought they could have done a more Yoda versus Palpatine-ish badass battle instead of ending it the way they did. I mean, sure, maybe it would not have fit him with him going around doing twirls there, but I thought that the whole climax, not the fact that Rey can beat Palpatine, I understand the whole part of, well, every Jedi lives in her, every Sith lives in Palpatine, but the fight itself was maybe not what I'd hoped for. I also love that we got to hear the voices of so many Jedi, including like Ahsoka and Kanan, so it's not just from the movies. I thought that was a very neat detail, and we actually waited and like saw the credits, because I didn't recognize all the voices the first time I heard that scene, but yeah, listening to those voices was great. And there was other details in the movie as well referencing certain parts of the universe that I really enjoyed, and we got to hear Palpatine say do it again. A silly meme, I know, and I just because I like Palpatine, I might be overseeing more with his return than others might do, but yeah, overall, to summarize what I thought of the movie, I enjoyed it. When I watched it, when I came out, I was happy. There was a lot of things where I was like, could they not have explained this more, could they not have done it differently? But overall, just as from a movie perspective, I really enjoyed it. And I think, as of now, it's my favorite out of the three sequel era movies. Bash me all you want, I know a lot of you will disagree, but that's how I felt seeing this movie. And it might change the more I see it. But yeah, I think those are my thoughts on the movie. A bit chaotic, I know. I didn't really have an order, I just wanted to sit down and talk about the movie, simply put. But please let me know what you thought in the comments below. I am very curious to hear. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, may the Force be with you.